Well, 1 year ago, the world was shutting down, and now it's thinking about reopening as things change with the pandemic, with a vaccine, and numbers, thankfully, for now at least, going down. And that's leading a lot of folks to get excited about things that may actually happen in 2021. It's also got it folks really looking at the changes they've made over the last year. So joining me now to talk about their pandemic pivot is Andrew Jorgensen. He is the General Director of Opera Theater St. Louis. Andrew, thanks for joining me.
Good afternoon. Thank you for having me.
Let's talk a little bit first about what you guys have already done to adjust to the pandemic. In this case, I loved it. You did Pirates of Penzance and some other programs online over the winter months. Tell us about these performances.
That's right. We were able to pivot and to transform our rehearsal spaces into a digital studio, and to take our education programs, which in a normal year would reach between 4,000 and 5,000 students in the St. Louis region in classrooms, we were able to transform that program into something that has now reached more than 75,000 students, literally from California to Kazakhstan, and from London to Johannesburg, South Africa. Hundreds of schools and tens of thousands of students, because we've seen such a successful adaptation to an online platform. Having said that, I can't wait to get back into the Opera House, and we are planning a season for 2021.
And that is super exciting. Just quickly, do want to touch on back to the winter though for just a moment. You worked with schools, and a lot of that was made completely available to the schools, but they also to the public for a little bit of a fee. Just that does allow you to bring in a little much needed revenue, but also it was such a an easy to take little fee for families to be able to enjoy this as well.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been wonderful. We were able to plan a holiday concert to do the Pirates of Penzance, not just for schools, but also to our public audience. And we've seen encouraging engagement, not just from an existing opera theater fan base, but actually a huge number of new-to-file patrons as well. I think people are sitting at home and looking for things to do with their families, looking for ways to engage. And it's been a helpful way for us to bring in new revenue, to meet new audiences, and to keep artists working despite the challenges that we couldn't come together in the normal ways that we would because of the pandemic.
All right, let's start thinking about summer because the weather's been so warm lately, it's easy to do. The outdoors has always been a big part of opera theater anyway, but not the performance. That is something is you guys have. I love the picnicking, I love the post show chats, but let's talk about this amazing season you guys have been working so hard to plan.
We are very excited this year that we will be taking the entire festival experience outside. As you say, Opera Theater is well known for those wonderful pre-show picnics and for those wonderful post-show receptions with the singers. But we knew that this year, even under the best circumstances, that things wouldn't be quite back to normal. And so rather than planning for a season in the Opera House, and holding on to the hope that things would be back to normal, we wanted to make plans that would help us keep art happening, whether or not things had gone back to normal. And so we will be turning one of the parking lots next to the Opera House on the campus of Webster University into an outdoor theater. We're working with Webster University, with the St. Louis Symphony, with the St. Louis County Health Department, and with our incredible teams of artists and designers to build an outdoor theater where we can bring together audiences and artists safely and in a way that is artistically satisfying. We plan about 290 seats in socially distanced pods of two. We plan to have full sets, full orchestra, full lights, full costumes, and all the quality of the opera theater experience. But to keep it safe, it'll be under the wonderful open skies, and we'll be experiencing the opera outside in a way that we never have before.
I love this. And of course, then it's up to me to make sure you have some good weather throughout the season. I never make promises to the Muni or to Shakespeare in the Park, though, either. So, but you know,
we'll be tuning in and watching every day with bated breath.
Send me a message. But yeah, you know, this is, people love being outside, and I think this is also a way that people are going to feel much more comfortable as they try to get back into some of these joyous performances. Some of them are a little harder than others, but in general, the joy of a live performance is always there, no matter the topic. And this is a great way to do it.
Thank you. We really felt like it was important to be as inclusive of our audience as we could be, and to really prioritize a safety protocol that ensures everyone will be comfortable when they come. We're working with a fabulous team of doctors at Washington University, infectious disease specialists, and we're following a really strict protocol for all of our artists to keep them bubbled and safe and tested, and also for our audiences to ensure that as people come to performances, they'll feel confident and to allow themselves to feel the joy of being outside and being back in groups. We're planning our pre-show picnics a little bit differently this year to keep everyone safe, but we're planning all of those traditions of the opera theater experience and hoping that together with our colleagues at the Muni and Shakespeare Festival, that we will be ushering in the summer and ushering back in the joy of live performance and the experience of the arts.
Did you ever think these were things you're going to be talking about when you were becoming an opera director?
Never in my life. The learning curve has been extraordinary. The idea that we have to plan rehearsals and cast sizes now based on the cubic volume and the air return of who can fit in a rehearsal space, this has been a new way of thinking. But I think that in response to these conditions, with the support of our extraordinary community, we've been able to be creative. We've been able to adapt. And the St. Louis community just has been so amazingly responsive to help us make this happen. Our supporters, our subscribers, they're rooting for us. And we can't wait to share the opera with all of you this coming spring, as we have in so many other years.
All right, so here's the most important question. How do we find out more information about this summer season, about what performances are going to be part of it, tickets, all that information? How do we find that all out?
We'll be making a public announcement with all of our plans and dates just in a couple weeks at the end of March. And tickets will be on sale to the general public at the end of April or in early May. Information will be on our website at experienceopera.org. And we will be sharing widely with the public all of these plans as we are now cruising forward with the support and partnership of the health department and all the right approvals towards making our season happen in just a couple of months.
That is Andrew Jorgensen. He is the general director of Opera Theater St. Louis. And I love how you guys have pivoted during this pandemic, but I also love how you guys are stepping back into a little bit of normalcy as we head towards summer 2021. Break a leg, all the best with all these new plans.
Thank you so much. We'll see you at the opera.